Should I be healthy? How and why the typecasting is used, and how the typecasting behaves at the time of compilation, and how the typecasting behaves at the time of execution. Okay? Now today, we are going to discuss a concept named constructor chaining. Okay? It's constructor chaining. Constructor chaining. Now, let me see here. Let me remove all the stuff. Now I have removed all the methods from person, employee and permanent employee. Okay? Just our intention is to discuss the constructor chaining. Now, we are going to discuss about constructor chaining. Now, let me write a simple example. No. Can I call a constructor directly like this? Can I call a constructor directly like this? Can we call a constructor directly like this? The constructor, okay, should be used with the combination of new operator only. Without the combination of new operator, we should not directly execute the constructor. Okay? We should not directly execute the constructor without the combination of new operator. You should not directly execute the constructor without the combination of new operator. If you do so, it will be a compile time error. And this will be a compile time error. Just because we are directly using the constructor without new operator. The constructor should not be used without a new operator. Constructor should be used in a combination of new operator. So, if you try to compile it, it will be a compile time error. Yes, it will be a compile time error. Okay. Without new, if we call any parenthesized verb, means it will consider that as a method. Without new, if we call any parenthesized member, it will, the compiler will consider that as a method call. A method call for that class. Okay? But a method doesn't exist with the name employee, okay, in inheritance demo class. So the compiler will consider that we are calling a method of the class inheritance demo, but it doesn't exist. Okay? So the constructor should be used only with the combination of new operator. No. What is the output? Which constructor will be executed? To which class we are creating the object? Employee class. So, definitely the employee constructor will be
executed.
So, the output will be? What is the output? First person constructor is executed, then the employee constructor is executed. But did we create an object to person class? No. If we did not create an object to person class, how come this person constructor is executed? Okay? That will explain. Okay? See? Now, for any constructor, for whatever the constructor it might be, and whatever the class it might be, maybe a constructor or subclass or superclass or whatever this constructor it might be, and maybe a constructor of nulls or augmented or whatever the constructor is, and whatever the constructor, whatever the class, and whatever the number of arguments, it's irrespective. For any constructor, the compiler will check. The compiler will check the first statement. We'll check the first statement as either super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis. Okay? For any constructor, the compiler expects the first statement to be either super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis. The parenthesis can be non-augmented or augmented. For any constructor, the compiler expects the first statement to be either super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis. And this parenthesis might be either non-augmented or we can set some parameters. Okay, the super followed by parenthesis, it need not to be empty, we can send even parameters also. Okay, but if it is augmented or augmented, it is irrespective. The compiler expects the first statement of the constructors to be either super followed by parenthesis with or without augments,
this follows the occurrences, either with or without occurrence. Okay? First statement of the constructor. The first statement of the constructor should be either super follow the occurrences or this follow the occurrences. Okay? And for a constructor, if the compiler doesn't find super followed occurrences or this followed occurrences as the first statement. For a constructor, if the compiler doesn't find super followed occurrences or this followed occurrences as the first statement, then the compiler will take the responsibility of putting a
this will be kept by the compiler. The compiler will take the responsibility of putting a super with no arguments. And the compiler can put only super with no arguments. The highlighted thing will be kept by the compiler.
Now, super followed by parenthesis is a calling statement of the superclass constructor. Super followed by parenthesis is the calling statement of the superclass constructor. This followed by parenthesis is calling statement of the current class constructor. Super followed by parenthesis is the calling statement of the superclass constructor.
This followed by parenthesis is calling statement of the current class constructor. Here, if you see here, the compiler has kept super followed by parenthesis, which is empty. Now, what it will do means it will make a call to the superclass no augmented constructor. Now, do we have any augmented constructor in the superclass? Yes or no? Yes. So, definitely it will go to the person class and it will execute the constructor in the person class. And again, it will come back to the employee class constructor and it will execute the employee class constructor. So, our output is first person constructor, then the employee constructor. Okay? Understood? This is how person constructor is being executed. See, the output is person and employee. Now, let me see super of 10. Now, what it will expect? Now, it's not generated by the compiler. Just I have kept this. Now, what it will expect means, in the super class, it will expect a constructor which is taking 10 as argument. Now, in the super class, do we have a constructor which can take 10 as argument? No. So, it will give a compile time error. So, it's telling that in a class person, it doesn't find any person constructor which takes int. Just because the first statement is super followed by parenthesis, which where we are sending 10 as argument. Okay, so it will check in the person class constructor, do we have any constructor which takes 10 as argument. But we don't find any constructor which takes 10 as argument, so it will be a compile time error. So now, will it compile and execute successful? Will it compile and execute successful? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. First, it will come to the employee constructor. In the employee constructor, now will the compiler place super followed by empty parenthesis? Will the compiler place super follow my empty parenthesis. No, just because if the compiler says a super follow my parenthesis with or without arguments, okay, or this follow my parenthesis with or without arguments as a first statement. If the compiler says super follow my parenthesis with or without arguments, or even this follow my parenthesis with or without arguments, then it will not place super follow my empty parenthesis. Okay, the compiler will place super follow my empty parenthesis if it doesn't see all these things as a first statement. But here we have super followed by parenthesis where we are sending some value. So the compiler will not keep, okay, this super followed by empty parenthesis. Okay, now what's the output? What is the output? Person, employee. Okay, temporarily. So person and employee. Wow. What's the output? Person? No. Is the employee constructor executed now? No.
Yes, sir.
Is the employee constructor executed?
Yes, sir.
Put a less? Let's see. No. Just see. For all the constructors, just see super and this. Super and this will be verified at the time of compilation only. Just see super and this followed by parenthesis as a first statement for all the constructors until the answer. I told that the compiler itself will verify whether there is a super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis. And if there is no super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis as the first statement, then the compiler will keep super followed by empty parenthesis. That's the thing that we have discussed, and this will happen at the time of compilation only. Okay? Based on that, analyze this example and tell the answer. Understood what I am telling? The compiler will verify for each and every constructor. The compiler will verify, okay, whether the first statement is super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis. If it is not so, then the compiler will keep super followed by empty parenthesis. That's what I told. Okay, based on that, just see the example and tell the answer. Thank you. What's the answer? Person. This will be a compile time error. Okay, that's what I told clearly. Okay, for each and every constructor, the compiler will verify what is the first statement. What is the first statement of employee? What is the first statement of employee? System dot dot dot. Is it super followed by parentheses or this followed by parentheses? No. So what the compiler will do? The compiler will keep super followed by empty parentheses as the first statement. What is super followed by empty parentheses? Is the calling statement of superclass normated constructor. Now in the super, what is the superclass for employee? What is the superclass for employee? Person. Now is there any normated constructor in the person? We have a calling statement, but we don't have a corresponding definition block. So what it will give? We are calling some block, but that block doesn't exist. We are calling some block and the block doesn't exist, then what will it leave? Definitely it will be a compile time error. Just because if we are calling some block and the block doesn't exist, obviously it will be a compile time error. That means we are calling a block that doesn't exist. So it will be a compile time error. Don't see whether we are using that constructor or not. Whether we are using that constructor is up to the runtime environment. Execution of the constructor is up to the runtime environment. But at the time of compilation only, the compiler will verify the super and this for all the constructors, for all the possible constructors. Okay? Understood? Understood? So this will be definitely a compile time error. Cannot find symbol, constructor, person with normals. Why? It is expecting a constructor person with normals means there is a super. Now, even in this case, it will expect the same. Okay? Just because now the super is there in my application. In an employee constructor, do we have any super followed by normals? Or this followed by any parentheses? No. So, the compiler will keep this super followed by empty parentheses. This will be kept by the compiler for any constructor. Now, now, what will it give? Definitely will be compile time error. Just see, what is the constructor? See, in the employee constructor, whatever the constructor it may be a constructor with norms or arguments. The compiler will follow the same rules. Okay? Just it will see the first argument. What's the first argument? The first argument is system dot dot dot. Sorry, the first statement. The first statement is system dot 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 println. It's not super, it's not this. So, what it will do means? It will keep a super followed by empty parentheses. This will be kept by the compiler. So, super followed by empty parentheses is a calling statement of the super class normated constructor. Now, person class doesn't have a normated constructor. So, this is a compile time error for the same reason. For the same reason, it is a compile time error. Okay? Now, let me keep super followed by parentheses where I am sending I. Now, will the compiler take the responsibility of putting a superfluo in parenthesis or superfluo in MBA parenthesis for employee constructor? No, just because I have called explicitly superfluo in parenthesis. Now, I am sending superfluo in parenthesis where I am sending a value I. What's the derivative of value I? Integer. Now, what it will check? It will check for a constructor in the superclass which can take integer. Now, in the superclass, do we have a constructor which can take integer? Yes. Now, what is the output? Now, what is the output? Person? Employee. For which class we have created the object? Employee class. So, what is the output? Person? Employee. Okay? Let us see what is output. This will be a compile time error. What's the link? What is the ceiling? Just see the error. What is the ceiling? It is telling that there is no normative constructor in the class employee. Why it is telling there is no normative constructor in the class employee? See, whatever the rule, construction chaining rule that is there for person and employee, it will be the same rule for even permanent employee also. Now, in the permanent employee, do we have any constructor? No. If there is no constructor, then the constructor will be placed by the compiler. I am giving comments, but this code will be generated by the compiler. Okay? Now, the compiler what will do? It will create a public constructor. The compiler will create a public constructor. Okay? And the compiler itself creates a constructor means, now the compiler itself will create the super, right? And the compiler can create only non-argumental super. The compiler can create only non-argumental super. So the compiler will put, now even this class is empty, even this class seems to be empty, this class seems to be empty, but actually it is not empty after the compilation. After compilation, at the time of compilation, what the compiler will do? If the compiler doesn't find any constructor in the class, then the compiler will create a constructor. Now, if the compiler itself creates a constructor, even super inside the constructor also will be created by the compiler. Now, the compiler created constructor will have super with empty parentheses. So, super with empty parentheses, which is created by the compiler, will be a calling statement of the super class normative constructor. But what is the super class for permanent employee? Employee. But do we have any constructor in the employee which is normative? No. For that reason, it will be a compile time error. Understood why this is a compile time error? For any constructor, for any class, if there is no constructor, means the compiler will put a constructor. For any class, if there is no constructor, means the compiler will put a constructor. It will be a public normative constructor. Okay? If the compiler itself is putting the compiler, the constructor itself is created by the compiler, definitely the super inside the constructor also will be created by the compiler. And the compiler can create only normative constructor and normative super. The compiler can create only non-argumental constructor and non-argumental super. So this will be a compile time error. Understood why this is a compile time error? Everybody? Because of the default constructor created by the compiler and the super which is kept by the compiler in the default constructor. The super with norms of permanent employee which is created by the compiler will be referring to the employee class normative constructor, but the employee class normative constructor doesn't exist. So let me put a constructor. Let me name it as P1. E1. E2. Now will it be compiled successful? Will it be compiled successful? Just see one second. Will it be compiled successful? Yes or no? It will never be compiled successful. Just because? See each and every constructor. Let's consider like, well, let's go from the bottom. Permanent employee. Permanent employee, is it having any constructor?
No.
No. So, the compiler will create a constructor. The compiler will create a public constructor. This will be created by the compiler. Okay? And normator super. Now, the normator super is pointing to the super class normator constructor. Do we have normator constructor in employee class? Yes. So, the chaining in permanent employee will be successful. Now, let's consider the chaining in the employee class. Now, employee class, the first argument is super followed by parenthesis where we are chaining I. Do we have a super class constructor which can take integer?
Yes.
Yes. Let's come to the second constructor. What's the second constructor? Employee constructor with norms. Whether we are using the constructor or not, it's irrespective. The semantic compilation, the compiler checks for the chaining in each and every constructor. Now, do we have super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis here? No. So, what the compiler will do? The compiler will keep a super followed by empty parenthesis. This will be kept by the compiler. Now, do we have a corresponding block for this? Do we have a corresponding block for this? No. So, this will be a compiler. Just because super followed by empty parenthesis, the highlighted content will be kept by the compiler for employee constructor, but such constructor doesn't exist in the super class. Okay? Understood? It's a compiler error. Now, what I'll do is, now will it be compiled? Will it be compiled? Will it be compiled? Yes or no?
Yes.
Definitely will be compiled successfully. Okay? See, let me come from the permanent employee. the permanent employee, we have a default constructor and a normalized super. So the normalized super will connect to employee class normalized constructor. Now in the employee class, the first constructor has super followed by integer as argument. Now do we have any constructor in the super class? Do we have any constructor in the super class which can take int? Yes, it will compile successfully. Now for the next one, this followed by parenthesis. Okay, now for the employee constructor with no arguments, for the highlighted constructor, will the compiler create a super followed by empty parenthesis? Will the compiler create super followed by empty parenthesis? Yes or no?
No.
Just because this followed by parenthesis is there. If the compiler doesn't find super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis, then only the compiler will create a constructor. Okay? Now, so this followed by parenthesis will make a call to the current class constructor. In the current class, do we have any constructor which can take int? Yes. So it will be like this. Now, what is the output? Just note down the output in your notes so that I can verify. It will be compiled successful, definitely. Okay, so let me go to the classes and I'll be executing this. Before I execute this, just analyze the output. What will be the output? Analyze the output and write it in notes so that it will be better. What's the output? P1, E1, that's fine. E2, first one is P1, E1, right? Again, P1, E1 and E2. That's fine. Just let me show you the output and why the output has come. P1, E1 and again P1, E1 and E2. Just because, first what it will do? First what, which object we are creating? Employee constructor by sending a 10 as an output. Now which way, where it will come? It will come to this constructor. Now in this constructor, what is the first statement? Super followed by parenthesis, where we are sending a integer. So it will make a call to the super class constructor which can take integer as a argument. Now where it will go? It will go to person constructor. Now in the person constructor, okay, just what it is doing is it has p1. So first is p1. Again, from the person constructor, from where the person constructor is being executed? Because of super. So it will come here and will execute e1. So for the first object creation, p1 and e1. See, for the second object creation, again Where it will come? It will come to the employee class normal constructor. Where the employee class normal constructor is here. See, it will make a call, this followed by parenthesis where we are calling 10. So, where it will go? It will go to the correct class constructor which could be able to take 10. Now, it will go to the employee class constructor which is taking 10. Okay? Again, from here, because of super, it will go to the person constructor. So, it will go for P1. After executing this, from where this constructor is being executed? From where this constructor is being executed? From the employee constructor which is taking int. So, it will come here back and it will execute E1. And from where this employee class constructor with int as argument is executed? Because of this. So, it will come here and it will go E2. So, P1, E1 because of the first object. P1, E1, E2 because of the second object. Okay? It will be like that. Just analyze the output like this and I'll give one more example. Not till the answer.
P1, E1, P2, E2.
Okay. Any other answer?
P1, P2, E2
is the correct answer. See, why the subclass constructor is executed for superclass object creation? See, somebody told like P1, E1. See, for which class we have created the object? For which class we have created the object first? Person. For the person class object creation, will the subclass constructors executed? For subclass object creation, subclass constructors will be executed. But for the superclass object creation, subclass constructors will never be executed. If we create an object to subclass, then there is a possibility to execute the superclass constructor because of super. But for the superclass object creation, subclass constructors will never be executed. It will not come down, it can go up. So, for person class constructor, what it will do means? Okay? Just it will come to this constructor and it will execute P1. And for employee class constructor, it will come here. Okay? And do we have any first of all, we need to check for compile time errors. Okay? See, here in the permanent employee, we have constructor which is generated by the compiler and it will be a non-committed super. So, for non-committed super, is there any corresponding constructor in the employee class?
Yes.
Now in the employee class, for the first constructor we have super, where we are sending 10 as a value, integer as a value. So in the super class constructor, in the super class, do we have a constructor which takes integer as a value? Yes or no? Yes. Now in the employee constructor, okay, now do we have any super followed by parentheses or this followed by parentheses? Yes or no? No. So the compiler will place super followed by empty parentheses. Now for super followed by empty parentheses, do we have any constructor in the super class? Yes. This is a person organized constructor. So this will be compiled successful. At the time of execution, it will come to the person constructor and will execute the p1 first. And then for the second constructor, what it will do? It will come to the employee constructor. Okay. But before executing the system.println, first it should execute super followed by empty parentheses, which is blessed by the compiler. So first it will execute the person class organized constructor p2, and again it will come to p2. So first, for the first object p1, for the second object p2 and e2. Okay, so the output will be p1 for the second object, p2 and e2. Now, what is the output? What's the output? P1? P2? P1, P2, E2. Okay, let's see what it will be. What is selling? It's a constructor. In the constructor, employee is selling that it is a compile time error. What is the reason that is selling? What is the reason that is selling? Recursive constructor invocation. What do you know? What is recursion? Calling the same executable block from the same block. Calling the executable block from the same block is called as recursion. Calling an executable block from the same block is called as recursion. Okay. The recursive constructor invocation using either super or this will be a compile time error. See, what is recursion means? Recursion means executing the same block from the same block. Executing an executable block from the same block is called as recursion. Okay, and executing the constructor recursively, either using super or this, will be a compile time error. Executing a constructor recursively, either using super or this, will be a compile time error. Okay, now can we execute a constructor without using the constructor, without creating the object? Can we execute a constructor without creating the object? Yes or no? What we are doing? We are trying to execute a constructor. The constructor execution cannot be triggered without creating object. But to execute a constructor, we need not to create the object for the class. See here, let's consider like we are creating the, let's consider like this statement is not there. Now we are creating an employee class object. Now in the employee class object, we are again executing the person class constructor. In order to execute the person class constructor, are we really creating the person class object? Are we really creating a person class object?
No.
See, in order to execute the constructor, it's not mandatory to create the object for that class. Or it's not mandatory to create the object using that constructor. To execute a constructor, it is not mandatory to create an object using that constructor. Even through constructor chaining also, we can execute the constructor. To execute a constructor, it is not mandatory to create an object using that constructor. Even in the constructor chaining, we can execute the constructor. But in the process of constructor chaining, if we call the same constructor recursively, then it will be a compile time error. Now what will happen? What will happen? Will it give a compile time error? Yes or no?
Yes.
Is it giving compile time error? No. What I told clearly, I told that, okay, if we call a constructor recursively using super or this, then it will be a compile time error. Now, are we calling the constructor recursively using super or this? No, it will never be a compile time error. Okay, just understand the difference. Now, at the time of execution, what it will do?
Is it a step? We have a stack and we have a heap. Okay? In the stack, what we do? Okay? Let's consider like it will be compile successful and first the main method will be coming to the picture. Okay? Main method will be coming to the picture for execution. And the main method, what is the first statement? We are creating the object. So, the object will be created in the heap.
object should be created in the name, and the here what we are doing from the object. Okay, after creating the object we have a general reference for the set, and after having the general reference what we do again make it go to the pattern. Let's consider like we are using constructor. Even the constructor will be executed from the set. Now the constructor what we are doing, the constructor what we are doing, we are creating a new object. So from here again a new object will be created. From here again a new object will be created. Again the constructor will be executed. If again the constructor is executed, what happens? Again the same constructor will come to the picture. So again a new object will be created in the constructor. Again the constructor will be executed. So like this, again and again the constructor, is executed. So what happens at a particular point of time? What is the default available heap size? Pointable memory. So the pointable memory is finished. What happens? It doesn't have any memory provided in the stack. So just it will give a runtime error that it is a stack overflow error. Just at the runtime what it will do? It will give a runtime error. This is a stack overflow error. The stack will have some specific memory, and if it is oversized, then it will give a stack overflow error. Understand why it is a stack overflow error? Just we are recursively calling the same constructor from the same constructor, and it is a never-ending process. So it is a stack overflow error at the runtime. If we create a object using a constructor within the same constructor, okay, if we create an object using the same constructor within the same constructor, then it will be a stack overflow error. Okay, if we create an object using a constructor within the same constructor, then it will be a stack overflow error. If we create an object using a constructor within the same constructor, then it will be a stack overflow error. Understand? No. Now, person is an attribute of the, let me make person as attribute to the person class. It's possible to make it, but it's irrelevant, but it's possible. It's irrelevant, but it's possible if you compile successfully. What happens? Just see, unless what happens.
Okay.
Now, can we call P as the attribute to person class? Can we call P as an attribute to the person class? Definitely yes. P will be an attribute to the person class. Now, just see the things. Draw the diagrams of the heap and tell the answer. See. Draw the diagrams of the heap and tell the answer. By seeing, you may not understand. For person object, what are the members? Just analyze. For person object, what are the members? We have id, name, int, p. How the members will be? Okay, just analyze that and tell the answer. Have you plotted the objects in the heap? Have you plotted the objects in the heap? If you have plotted the objects in the heap, then you can get the answer easily. Stack? Why it is a stack overflow? Okay. See?
Let's consider from the same method we are getting a person object. Right? We are getting a person object. Okay? Then now, what are the members of the object? What are the members of the person object? ID, whose value is 0? 7, right? What is the name value? Null. Count will not be there in the object. Person P, what is the value of person P? Is it null? No. What is the value of P? P is, the value of P is another object. Okay, here what we are doing, we are creating another object and we are referring to P. Okay, but what is that another object? Which class another object is? Person. Again, whatever object might be, wherever it is created, again, you have ID. name. Again, please represent another object. And again, the object will have ID, name, P. Where P is creating the object. Like this. Okay? The heap will be overflow. Okay? Like this, the heap will be
overflow.
So, go to SRC, clear the screen, compile this. Let's compile this and execute this. Okay, even the heap is overflown, the error to represent the stack overflow or heap overflow is the same. It's stack overflow error only. Actually, the heap is overflown, but the error that is used to represent is the same. Stack overflow error. The error is the same. Okay, the error, stack overflow error, is used to represent both the stack overflow as well as the heap overflow scenarios. Okay, for both the scenarios, it will be the same error.
Understood why it is an error? Understood everybody? Why it is a runtime error? Just because recursively the same object has reference to the same object. But this is not a likely scenario. Some of the interviews will be asking these questions.
This is not a likely scenario in real-time environment. But some of the interviews will be asking, what will happen? I think we have deviated a little bit from the constructor chaining. Now, what's the output? So, permanent, if you see the permanent employee, let's not bother about these things, not to go at present. Now, what's the output? The permanent employee doesn't have any constructor which takes 10. Now, 1 second, just allow me. Then, what's the output? What's the output?
E1, E2.
Okay. Just, there is a slight correction, just think 1 second. Almost you have reached, but it's not exact.
E2, E2, E2.
E2 E1 E2 That's the correct answer. Okay, that's how you need to analyze. Okay, the answer could be P2 E1 E2 again P2 E1 P2 E1 E2 P2 E1 just because let's consider from the permanent employee. The permanent employee doesn't have any constructor, so the compiler will create an augmented constructor and augmented super. So because of the permanent employee object creation, it will make a call, the permanent employee constructor, okay, doesn't exist, so the compiler will create a permanent employee constructor with default super, which is normal. So because of this, it will make a call to the super class constructor, which is employee. Okay, in the employee, what we are doing, again we are calling current class constructor by sending 10. It will come here. Now here also we have super followed by empty parenthesis, which will be placed by the compiler. Because of this, where it will go? It will go to person class normal constructor. So P2. From where this person class normal constructor is executed? From employee class constructor. So again E1. From where this employee class constructor with int is executed? From employee class normal constructor. So go for E2. So P2, E1, E2 for the first object. Let's consider for the second object. We are calling the employee constructor by passing 10. So it will go directly come here. Okay? And it will make a call to the super class normal constructor. So P2 again E1. So P2, E2, E1 and P2. P2 E1 E2 and P2 E1. Like this, like that, you need to analyze the answers for constructor chaining. Okay? I don't tell this simple, but upon practice, you can analyze it better. Now I have created permanent employee which takes integer, but I am not using the permanent employee. No, you will not be able to see out, so we can have some space. No. What is the output? Okay, let me change this application a little bit. P2? Why did you tell the correct answer previously, and why you could not able to tell the correct answer now? Just think one second. See, that's why I have told at least 100 times in this class itself. Before trying to check for the execution, first check for the compilation. If everything is compiled successful, then only check how the execution will be. See, first check the individual classes and individual constructors. Check the employee constructor. Now, employee constructor is the first statement super or this? Is the first statement super or this? No. So, compiler plus super follower means not means in the super class we have normal constructor. Now, for this constructor is the super or this? Yes. This follower and this. So, in the current class, this constructor exists. But in here, permanent employee, do we have super of this as a first argument? No. The compiler will place super with empty arguments. So this is a default super. And for this calling statement, do we have any corresponding block? For this calling statement, do we have a block in the employee constructor? No. So this will be a compile time error. So that's why for each and every constructor, just at the time of compilation itself, check whether the constructor chaining is possible here or not. If the constructor chaining is not possible, then it will be a compile time error. If there is any deviation, then it will be a compile time error. Here, there is a super, whether we are using the constructor or not, it is irrespective. It's up to runtime. But for the compiler, for each and every constructor, it should have either super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis as the first statement. And for each and every super or this, there should be a corresponding constructor. Otherwise, it will be a compile time error. Okay? Otherwise, it will be a compile time error. Now, this is a compile time error just because permanent employee constructor has an augmented super, but in the super class employee, it doesn't have a corresponding constructor. Okay. It's expecting an augmented constructor but doesn't exist. Let me give. Now, will it be compiled successful? Yes or no? Yes. Now what is the output? What's the output? Error? Why it will be error? Huh? Argument type? String. Why it will be a compile time error? Just tell the reason why it is a compile time error. In the permanent employee, okay, we have int, right? No? So what happens? P2? P2 even? E2? What's the output? P2, E1, E2, P2. First, it will call the permanent employee constructor, and the permanent employee, it will make a call to the supervisioning null. Supervisioning null means which can take a class as an attribute. There is an employee constructor which can take a class as attribute, which is a string. So it will come here again. From this, it will go to the employee constructor. From employee constructor, because of super followed by empty parenthesis, it will go to the person class constructor. And from the person class constructor, okay, now it will return back to the employee class. And from P2, E1, E2. Again, it will come here, and because of person class constructor, it will be P2. But for 1.5 hours, I am expecting some doubt from you.
What is public?
The constructor with access level public. Public constructor means a constructor with access level public. Constructor can have any access level: private, default, protected, public. Public constructor means a constructor which is having access level as public. Okay? From 1.5 hour, I am expecting at least one of you persons will ask one doubt. But still, I am not getting that.
If there is no supervisor,
that is taking object, I have a
constructor,
it is
object,
and
we are passing null, then we.
Well, in which statement you are telling? It should not be like that. Okay, we should pass a specific value of the specific class. But just temporarily, I am doing that. That's what I am asking. That's what I am expecting from you. I thought that at least one of you will ask this question, and I can tell the answer at that time. Okay? See, what I told, for each and every constructor, if there is no super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis, there will be the compiler will create a super followed by empty parenthesis. Now, will there be super followed by empty parenthesis even for person constructor? Yes, even person constructor is a constructor. Even for person constructor, it will be a super followed by empty parenthesis. This will be kept by the compiler. This will be kept by the compiler. Now, do we have any super class for person? No. Okay? Then, where this call will go? See, where this call will go, where it will refer. See, if person class has a constructor and the constructor doesn't have any super or this followed by parenthesis, then the compiler will place super followed by parenthesis for any constructor. It might be super class or subclass or subclass or its subclass. Whatever the constructor it might be. For any constructor, if there is no super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis, the compiler will put a super followed by empty parenthesis. Now, see, if we have this constructor, let's consider that. This is super followed by empty parenthesis, which is a calling statement of employee constructor. And here we have a super followed by parenthesis, which is a calling statement of person class non-permanent constructor. Now here super followed by parenthesis is there. Where it will go? Right now we have not already discussed that. So some of the persons may not know. Okay? So we have a person class non-permanent constructor. In the person class non-permanent constructor, we have super. See, from employee constructor, if I call super means, it will call person. From person, if I call super, where it will go? The person doesn't have any super class. Where it will go?
Main.
Will go to a method. Will it go to a method? It should go to a constructor, right? Where it will go? Means for each and every class, for any class, if any class is not a subclass to another class, then what the compiler will do means the compiler will extend the class with a class named object which is there in the library. The compiler finds that the class is not extending with any other class. If the compiler finds that the class is not extending with any other class, then the compiler will make the class as a subclass to object class. The compiler finds that the class is not extending with any class. The compiler finds that a class is not extending with any class, then the compiler will make the class as a subclass to object class. Object class is a class in the library. Object class is a class in the library. Object class is a class in the library. And object class is a supermost class for any class in Java. Object class is the supermost class for any class in Java. Now, if you see here, object class is a supermost class for any class in Java. Now, if you see this example, we have a permanent employee. Now, for permanent employee, will the compiler extend it with the object class? For permanent employee, will the compiler extend it with the object class? Yes or no? No, just because it already extends to employee. For employee, will the compiler extend to person? Sorry, will the compiler extend to object class? No, just because already employee extends to person. Now let's come to person. For person, will the compiler take the responsibility of extending the person class to object class? Yes or no? Yes, just because person is not a subclass to any other class. So now, can I call permanent employee is a subclass to object? Can I call permanent employee is a subclass to object? Yes or no? Yes, just because the compiler has made person as a subclass to object, internally employee will be a subclass to object, and even permanent employee also will be a subclass to object. In turn, any class in Java will be a subclass to object class. Either directly or indirectly, any class in Java will be a subclass to object. Now, permanent employee is a subclass to object class through its superclass person. Okay, because of person. Okay, which is superclass to employee? Because of employee, which is superclass to permanent employee. So internally, permanent employee is a subclass to object, not directly to employee and employee to person. So at any point of time, okay, object class will be a superclass for any class in Java, and the object class will be there in the library, and there will be only one constructor in the object class, that is the operator constructor. There is only one constructor in the object class, and that is a public operator constructor. Object class has only one constructor, that is a public operator constructor.
But in case of multi-leveling, it is directly extend the object class also. It is by extend with person, and indirectly.
Because
person is person extends in the object, then it has to be implied in the object.
You can see? Let's consider this hierarchy. Person, permanent employee extends to employee and employee extends to person. Now, can I call permanent employee as a plus of person?
Yes? The same way? You can call employee as a plus to object.
Object class has only one constructor, that is an augmented constructor. Object class doesn't have any attributes, and object class has 9 methods. Object class has 9 methods, and those 9 methods are very, very important. Each and every method has a specific purpose. What is the purpose of those 9 methods? We will discuss later on when the time comes. But each and every object class method has its own importance. Okay? And why those methods are used, we'll discuss when the time comes. But make it a note, like object class has only one constructor, that is a public normative constructor, and 9 methods and no attributes. Okay? Now, what's the output? Let me remove this. What's the output? Let me remove this. Now, what's the output? And the object class constructor will be empty. Nothing will be there, no statements will be there. What's the output? P1, P2, E1, E2, and again P1, P2. Here, it will come here, it will search for an augmented super class constructor. It has an augmented super class constructor. Here, it will call the integer, the current class constructor which can take integer. Here it will try to find out a superclass constructor which is augments. Superclass constructor which is augments is there. And here it will check the current class constructor which can take int. The current class constructor which can take int is there. Now here it will have a superclass constructor. It will make a call to superclass constructor which is augments. Now, do we have a corresponding calling statement? Do we have a corresponding executable block here for this super? Do we have a executable block? Yes or no?
Yes.
The super with normals will make a call to the object class normative constructor. Definitely, object class has a normative constructor. So, the object class normative constructor is empty. So, first what it will do? For the first object creation, where it will come? First it will come to this constructor. Now from here, because of the augmented super which is placed by the compiler, it will go to this constructor. From here, because of this followed by parenthesis which where I am sending 10, it will make a call to the correct class constructor where I am sending 10. So it will call to this constructor. From here, because of super followed by empty parenthesis, it will make a call to the super class constructor where I am sending 10. So here, because of this followed by parenthesis, it will make a call to this correct class constructor which is taking 10. Here, because of super, it will make a call to the object class normal constructor. When it returns from the object class normal constructor, first it will execute P1. From where this constructor is being called? From here. So it will execute P2. From where this constructor is being called? From here. So it will execute E1. From where this constructor is called? From here. So it will execute P2. So P1, P2, E1, E2 for the first object creation. And for the second object creation, that it will execute. From here, it will go to the current class constructor. From here, it will go to the object class constructor. And after returning from the object class constructor, it will execute P1 and then P2. P1 and P2. Understood? Like that, it will be. Okay? P1, P2, E1, E2, P1, P2. Oh. So what is output? What is the output? Just see once again. It will be definitely a compile time error. Just because here it's referring to super where I am sending 10. But in the object class, we don't have any augmented constructor. The object class will have an augmented constructor. So from the supermost class in the inheritance hierarchy, we should call only super followed by empty parenthesis. We should not send any super followed by value. We should not call super followed by some arguments in the supermost class in the inheritance hierarchy. See, what is the supermost class in this inheritance hierarchy? Okay? Permanent employee, employee and person. In this inheritance hierarchy, super class is the person. See? From the super class of the inheritance hierarchy, we should not call super by sending some value. Just because it will be a subclass to object class and object class doesn't have any augmented constructors. From the super class in the inheritance hierarchy, we should not call super by sending values. Understood?
Sir, can we write object release of super because super is a class and
the
constructor name also object?
We cannot create the object directly by using the name of the constructor. We should have new. See, if you want to create an object directly, we cannot directly call the constructor like this. We should call new. Then only we can create an object. Without using new, we cannot directly call the constructor using the constructor name. It's not possible. Okay? Now, because of this, I got something. See, this is my thing. What is the output? Thank you.
What's the output? P1? P2? E1, E2? See, it will be twice P1, P2, E1, E2. Okay? Just because this will not be considered as super or this. Okay? The compiler will search for exact super or this. Okay? If it doesn't find super or this, then this will be replaced by the compiler. Because of the super, it will go to employee constructor and employ here. From here it will go here. From here it will go here. And P1, P2, E1, E2. And because of employee object creation, again it will call the employee constructor and again the same flow will happen. So, twice it will execute P1, P2, E1, E2. Okay, P1, P2, E1, E2, P1, P2, E1, E2, and again P1, P2. Just because of the second object creation, it executed P1, P2. And again, now. Let me see here. One second, give me 1 minute. Just let's complete the things. No. What's the output? What's the output? Why? Huh? If it is not there as a first statement, the compiler will create the super, no? Huh? It's not there, right? See, it's not there, right? Is it there in the first statement? No, definitely the compiler will create super with normals. See, super with arguments will be expected as the first statement. If it is not there as the first statement, definitely it will create. Okay? But this will be a compiler error because of not because of the reason that you told. Okay? But the compiler has a rule that super followed by parenthesis should be the first statement of the constructor. Okay? But you are telling that the compiler will not create super followed by parenthesis here. The compiler will create super followed by parenthesis if it doesn't see a super followed by parenthesis as the first statement. But it is a compile time error because it is there in the third line. Because of this, it is a compile time error. But it's not a compile time error because of the reason that you told. What the reason that you told is, if it is there in the third statement, then it will not create the super by empty parenthesis. But it's not the case. For this constructor, the compiler will create super by empty parenthesis definitely. But after creating this, the compiler will come to the next statement. There is no compile time error here. Okay, and the compiler will come to the next statement. Yes, there is a compile time error here because super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis should be the very first statement of the constructor. But is this the first statement of the constructor? No. So it will be a compile time error. Understood? Understood? Super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis will be the and should be the first statement of the constructor. Okay? If it is the second or third statement, obviously it will be a compile time error. Here we have created object. Obviously it will call a constructor because the first statement will be super. The first, what is the first statement? See here, the first statement, this is a permanent employee constructor. What's the first statement here? Is it a super or this? It's not super, it's not this. So first it replaces super followed by empty parenthesis. So first it will make a call to the super class constructor and the corresponding constructors, and again it will come to the end of this statement. After ending this statement, again it will create an object. In the constructor we can create object. See, for this statement you are asking? For this statement? For this statement, will be the object created first or will be the constructor executed first? Definitely, as we told in the first classes itself, first object is created, attributes will be loaded, then reference will be created, temporary reference, and then only the constructor will be executed. For any object, wherever the object is created, it's the same. Okay?
Constructor table was creating object of the super class. Then how do you access non-static variables of super class using reference of super class?
Using the reference of the subclass?
If we create the object of the subclass, then also we can access the non-static variables of super class using the reference of the super class.
Definitely.
Non-static variables are stored in object. If they are not creating object of the super class,
obviously non-static variables of the super class will be the members of the subclass.
They will also be members.
Yes. Even the non-static members of the super class will be the members of the subclass objects.
And if there is two actions of same name,
then it will ignore first. See, while loading the attributes into the object itself, it will check. Already do we have any attribute with the same name? If there is attribute with the same name, then the attribute will not be loaded into the object. See, first what it will do? First it will create object. Then it will load the attributes of the current class. Then next step it will load the attributes of the super class. Then what it will do? Let's consider like the super class is person. Here, permanent employee is a class and employee class is. Then let's consider like int id is there in the employee as well as id is there in the permanent employee. Okay, while creating the object to permanent employee, first what it will do? First it will create the object and it will load id into permanent employee. Now it should load the id of the employee into permanent employee. Now what will happen means it will check. Already, is there any attribute with the name id in the permanent employee object? Is it there? Yes. If it is there, it will not load the attribute into the permanent employee object. Even if I refer new employee, like new permanent employee dot id, which will be referred? Will it refer the attribute of the permanent employee or the employee? Definitely, just because the object contains the id which is there in the permanent employee. This doesn't exist in the object, that scenario. This attribute doesn't exist in that object, in that scenario. But let's consider like id is not there. Now what it will do? There is no attribute in the permanent employee. Let's consider like we have a name in the permanent employee. We have name in the permanent employee. Now it will load the name into the permanent employee object when it comes to the super class. Now it should load id into the permanent employee object. Now before loading the id into the permanent employee, it will check. Already is there any attribute with the name id in the permanent employee object? Do we have any id in the permanent employee object? Yes or no? No. So it will load this attribute into the permanent employee. Like that, the object creation and loading the attributes will happen. So because of that reason, if we have the same attribute in the superclass as in the subclass, okay, And if you are using the subclass object, then the subclass attribute will be referred.
If we use the type class as a current superclass,
yes, definitely. Just because if it is a reference variable, if it is a reference variable, okay, the reference variable will be referring to the class. The reference variable for attributes, it will refer the class. Okay, so the reference variable, let's consider that we are now, are we using the reference variable or the object? We are using the object to point the attribute. If you use the reference variable to point the attribute, let's consider like we did like this and we refer p1.id. Then if you use the reference variable to point the attributes, then it will not check in the object. It will check in that class itself.
But one of the variables
is stored in the object. Yes. Non-static variables will be created in the object. But it doesn't mean that non-static variables will not be available for the references of the class. Non-static attributes will be pumped into the object when the object is created. That's for sure. That doesn't mean that non-static attributes will not be available for the references of the class. Non-static attributes will be the members of the object, as well as non-static attributes will be available for the references of the class. Okay? Okay. Now, just to recap the things, a super followed by parenthesis or this followed by parenthesis should be the first statement. Otherwise, it will be compiled time. Okay. There are several things to discuss in constructor chaining, and even we have not yet discussed what is the definition of constructor chaining. Okay, all of you got a brief picture like how the constructor chaining works, and in tomorrow's class we will discuss some more things about constructor chaining and we define the constructor chaining. Once this constructor chaining is completed, the core part of this Java will be completed, the basic part, the very basic thing. And the next concept will be exception handling.